about what is happening in Derby and how it has made us feel unappreciated, undervalued, and that we just don't.
Microphone!
Sorry. We couldn't shout out that much from the front. Sorry. My name is Kate Walker, and I'm not used to speaking in public. I'm a TA, and I should be in schools talking and supporting children in the classroom. However, but because of what our Labour Council have done to us, we have no option but to come out and tell our stories. So here I go. I'm 46, a wife and a mother of two fantastic children. I used to be a self-employed childminder, which I did for over 10 years. During this time, I gained a great deal of knowledge and experience supporting and working with special needs children and their families. It was a good job, but I felt my skills and knowledge would be better put to use working in schools. I applied to be a Level 2 Additional Needs Teaching Assistant in the only Key Stage 1 Nurture Group in Derby. I was ecstatic when I received the phone call to say I'd got the job. I promise I would always do above and beyond what was expected of me to make sure these children achieve their full potential. The group consisted of three TAs and six children, and we catered for the most vulnerable children from across the city. I was sworn at, kicked, hit and bitten, spat at on a daily basis, but I was making a difference to those children's lives. They learned to trust adults again, and no matter what they did to me, I would always be there for them tomorrow. It was my forever job. Everything was great till June last year, when my family's lives changed, and not in a good way. I was called into the head teacher's office and asked to sit down. She told me I was going to lose 25% of my salary due to the council's equal pay review. They changed our pay and grading and our terms and conditions. I was, however, offered an additional 34 hours a month to help cut my losses, but I was still going to lose. I accepted the hours as I had financial commitment. Food for my family, some utility bills, pet insurance, fuel for my car, and money to support my daughter, none of which I considered were luxury items. As I stood up to leave the room, she told me these additional hours are temporary until the 1st of April 2017. Oh, and don't discuss this with anybody else in school because some have lost more than others. I later found out I had lost the most, and even worse, our special group was to close. As the months passed and April 1st got closer and still no reasoning with the council, we knew we had to do something drastic, otherwise I could lose everything. We cut back at home wherever possible, but it wasn't nearly enough. So my husband took a new job, which involves him working away from home for periods of time. My daughter, who's in her final year at university, had to take an extra one or two shifts a week just to pay her rent. And when I asked my son what he wanted for his birthday, he said, "Nothing, Mum, we can't afford it." I looked at alternative employment away from schools, but I love my job and I'm damn good at it. I'm one of the lucky ones. I have an amazing husband. Thank you. Sorry. I'm one of the lucky ones. I have an amazing husband who is supporting action and encouraged me to fight what is so obviously unfair and morally wrong. Derby City Council need to sit down and sort out and stop the suffering of us, our families, the parents, but most of all the children. None of us want to be out striking. We want to be back in school doing what we do best. There have, however, been some positives from this dispute. Incredible friendships made, new skills learned, and stronger people built, all of which will continue long after Ranjit Braithwaite has gone. So on behalf of Derby support staff and their families, I would like to thank Derby Youth and City Bunch for their continuing support, guidance, and positive attitudes while things have been bleak. Dave Prentice for his backing encouragement for us to continue to fight what the council have done so wrong. and finally you for listening and showing us we do matter. There is a statement being passed round, and if you would support us by signing it, that'd be really appreciated. Thank you.
My name is Nicol Hutley. I'm 41 years old. I'm married with three children. And I've been working as a special needs assistant for 5 years with a special needs primary school, the only one in Derby that we have at the moment. My job role is always changing to suit the needs of the children. And in the last academic year, my children had very difficult behavioural needs, which resulted in injuries both to myself and my colleagues. Whereas this year, my cohort of children consists of manual handling and medical needs, and this has all required additional training. Within my school, there are 40 teaching assistants, and we are a team. We are a family that support and nurture each other. Within our school, there are 120 pupils, all with various needs, and every single one of those teaching assistants, all 40 of us, makes a difference, those pupils. Not only are we there to ensure their educational needs are met, but also their personal, their social, and their medical needs. And this, I'm proud to say, is all done in a safe and nurturing environment. None of this could be achieved without myself and my colleagues' dedication, experience, and willingness to professionally develop to meet the children's needs. However, as you've already heard, on the 1st of June 2016, this all changed. We'd had various meetings before regarding the equal pay review, and in each of those meetings, nobody really told us because nobody knew what was actually going to happen. However, the outcome of all of that was delivered in a generic letter, and I will always remember and never forget watching these strong professional women, my friends, being reduced to tears when they realised they were going to lose 25% of their pay. I had to watch as one of my colleagues, one of my friends, left the hall broken and did not return to school for 4 months due to the stress of it all. Within my school, we've been lucky, if you can say that, in that they've been able to mitigate some of the loss by giving us 37 hours permanent. Even though before all of this happened, everyone worked until the jobs were completed. Everybody stayed and made sure the children were getting the best. Nobody worked 32 hours, like our Labour councillor stated, that they're calling us part-time workers. No one was part-time, we all work and continue to work really hard. So how has this affected me personally? Firstly, out of the amazing 40 teaching assistants that I am proud to call my colleagues, my work family, one teaching assistant had gone off for 4 months for stress, but she's returned and she's now fighting alongside us. One teaching assistant has just sold a house because she could no longer afford the payments and is now left to work elsewhere. Another teaching assistant, one of my very dearest friends, left due to stress and now works for the NHS. And others in my school have left to work in other counties and they've just been replaced by newly qualified teaching assistants with no experience. Because of this unfair process, our school has lost over 81 years of experience so far. And I've had to watch this happen to my colleagues, and I've had to say goodbye to very, very dear friends. For myself, I'm one of the lucky ones in that my husband is a nurse, so now he has to work extra shifts to cover my loss. All our savings have almost gone to top up the deficit in our accounts and to be able to support our eldest daughter through university. And our youngest son is now no longer able to attend his extra activities and doesn't understand why we're both always working and why we're both so stressed. What I don't understand in all of this is I've always worked hard, my husband has always worked hard, and we have passed this work ethic onto our children. How do I explain to my daughters, one who's completing her degree and one who's completing her A-levels, that if you work hard and you gain qualifications, you will be rewarded with a job that has decent pay and great prospects, when at this moment all we have been rewarded with is pay cuts, stress, and a great deal of uncertainty? How can I bring my girls up to have those moral standards when it's not happening to us? So before I finish, I want to say that Unison have been amazing. The support they've given us has been fantastic. We were just normal women doing our jobs that we love, and now I can happily say we're all warriors. We are fighters. Wherever we go and talk about this, the support we get is just amazing. We would not have had the courage to fight Derby City Council. So I just want to say thank you very much. Thank you very much for listening to us, and please.